A UN special rapporteur calls on Philippine authorities to drop perjury charges against human rights defenders filed by National Security Advisor Hermenes Esperon. Esperon's perjury case against officers of Carapatan, Gabriela, and the Rural Missionaries of the Philippines was based on a dismissed plea for protection in habeas corpus filed with the Supreme Court, which named Esperon as respondent. In a statement, UN Special Rapporteur on Human Rights Defenders Mary Lawlor called on the Philippines to stop targeting human rights defenders and instead urged it to promote and protect their work. Belgium-based NGO Viva Salud issued a similar appeal, saying the case is evidently a retaliatory act against the groups who are seeking court protection over increasing attacks, intimidation, and red tagging by government officials and security forces. Carapatan Secretary General Cristina Palabay is scheduled to take the witness stand at a Quezon City court today. Vice President-elect Sara Duterte Carpio takes her oath as the Philippines' second highest leader Sunday, 11 days before she officially assumes office. The oath-taking was held at the San Pedro Square in her hometown of Davao City. The incoming vice president was sworn in by Supreme Court Associate Justice Ramon Paul Hernando. She was joined on stage by her parents, President Rodrigo Duterte and Elizabeth Zimmerman.
I, Sara Zimmerman Duterte,
do solemnly swear, that I will faithfully and conscientiously fulfill my duties as Vice President of the Philippines. Preserve and defend its constitution. Execute its laws. Do justice to every man. And consecrate myself to the service of the nation. So help me God. Congratulations and all the best.
In her inaugural speech, Duterte Carpio focused on family values and her belief in God. She also called on families to be reminded of their duty to educate their children at home. Duterte Carpio will serve as the education secretary in the incoming administration of her running mate, President-elect Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.
We should not, as we cannot afford, to squander the future of our children. The days ahead may be full of challenges that call for us to be more united as a nation. But let me reiterate this. We can never go wrong if we are a people dedicated to honoring the will of God, to serving our country and our fellow men, and protecting the integrity of our families and the future of our children. Ako po si Inday Sara, a proud Davaoenia, very proud, a proud Mindanaon. Hindi ako ang pinakamagaling o pinakamatalinong tao sa Pilipinas at sa mundo. Ngunit walang makakatalo sa tibay ng puso ko bilang isang Pilipino.
Gabby earlier said she took her oath 11 days ahead of the usual June 30 inauguration so that she could attend Marcos Jr.'s own inaugural ceremony in Manila.
The Marcos family also present during the inauguration of Vice President-elect Sara Duterte Carpio. President-elect Marcos expressed confidence Duterte Carpio will do a great job as VP.
So proud of her. She's going to be great. She'll do a great job. I know it.
Senator Aimee Marcos, who played a major role in forming the Marcos-Duterte alliance in the recent elections, was all praises for the incoming vice president, too. The senator thanked outgoing President Duterte as well for all he was able to do in his 6-year term and vowed to be allies of the family for life.
Salamat lang ako kay Presidente. Ang sabi niya, lahat mong ginawa. Tapos sabi ko, ang dami mong ginawa, in 6 years, ginawa mong proud ang Pilipino. The Duterte family can count on us. Davao can count on us. And Mindanao will always be a priority as it was during my father's time. Hindi yan magbabago.
In the run-up to the 2022 national polls, critics of the Marcos Duterte tandem floated discussions about the latter possibly ousting the scion and namesake of former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. from power. Their camps repeatedly denied talk of rift within their so-called unity.